Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do an acrylic painting inspired by the Grand Canyon around sunset time, maybe just after sunset. We're going to be using acrylic paints today and an 11 inch by 14 inch canvas. Our paints today are cadmium red light, yellow ochre, flesh tint, Mars black, light blue violet, ultramarine blue, burnt umber, burnt sienna, crimson, dioxazine purple, and titanium white. I'm mostly going to be using flat tip brushes like this one and a little bit thicker than this today. And we also have a cup of water and some paper towels for wiping down our brushes. So I'm going to start by sketching out the scene here. A little tick in the center. And we're going to start with the top. Just a little line there. It's closer to the top than that section. And we're going to bring this down. Down again. And back up a little. And then on this side, starting at that same point from up and down as this one, like if you do an imaginary line all the way across, this one's at that same level, comes to about here, then goes down. And down some more. And here I'm just gonna do start sketching out this next one. Comes down just a little bit lower than this one, but following that same pattern. We got a couple layers of darker rock in there. I'm just gonna shade that in real quick so we remember those are a little darker. And comes down there and just past center point, comes over like this. One follows that same pattern, comes out a bit more for this one. And we got another little guy sticking out over here. Move back over to this side. This one kind of comes in here. This is our canyon right in here, so we want to get that nice and obvious. And we've got one right here that's a little bit lighter. It's maybe more in the sun. And another one right here. Oops, let's bring it down some. Got this little darker one down here. It's really dark down in there. Just gonna block that in real quick. And there we go, we matched these guys back up. We got here. We got one This is all pretty light rock bedding here. Kind of follow the same horizontal line for the shadows. Getting these angles here. Once you get this all sketched out, everything gets a little bit easier. I think the trickiest part of painting the Grand Canyon is just accurately, well, I guess there's a couple tricky things, but accurately sketching it is probably the first major challenge. Then you gotta match value and color, which can be pretty tricky for the Grand Canyon. start with that. I'm gonna take my flat tip brush here and take some light blue violet and ultramarine blue and a little dioxazine purple, some white and flush tint. And that's a good color. I'm gonna blend a little more of that. Covering up all the white space here. Put that brush in the water and go back to my smaller flat tip brush. And now we can start to paint these rocks. So I'm gonna take some flesh tint with crimson and ochre. And I want it to be a little cooler, so I'm gonna take some white and purple. That's better. And I'm just gonna go right up to the outline. And next level down, we've got more. This color. We can take more white with a little bit of purple. A little crimson. And we want to go lighter in value here. I'm going to take more white, a little more ochre, a little bit of brown for this one. And more flesh tint for this one. All right, and same up here. A little bit of brown and crimson and sienna. Crimson and violet and umber. A couple little spots in here are darker. A little bit of my warmer red. which is the cadmium red light. And I'm just adding a few more of these deeper reds in here, try not to overdo it. I still get what I need in there. Okay. And next we need some deoxyzine purple and light blue violet. That just goes right here on top of, gonna mix a little bit of flesh tint in there so it's not so dark. Just put it right on top of that last bit you had there. You can add a couple little bushes in here too. Okay, now let's take some of our burnt sienna, crimson, and deoxyzine purple. Seems a little dark. We'll mix a little bit of flesh tint in there. A little bit of brown, a little more flesh tint. And that's pretty good for this one. And some more purple back here. Take more deoxyzine purple. Start to build some of that up in here. Take some white, light, cadmium red light. And I'm just gonna put this all here. Just like a more muted gray looking red. And then we'll take some white, cadmium red light, and ochre. A little bit more red. And that's gonna go under there. And then we're going to take our light blue violet and doxazine purple and ultramarine blue and white. Start. Let's take some flesh tint too. Let's take some of this in here. Pretty dark back in here, and it's pretty dark in here, kind of blends in to the other ones. Same over on this side. Take some white and some umber, just warm this purple up a little. Gray in here too, definitely needs it. A little bit lighter here on each of these things, and then we're going to take more ultramarine. Lightening this up a little more again. Okay. And we're going to darken behind each of these. And just blend that out a little more. Mix in more of my crimson in here with my cadmium red light and ochre. Just doing some vertical brush strokes here to show this rock unit. You want to basically continue it straight all the way across. Just a couple little variations where it might go up or down. And I'm going to lighten up this down here with more white and flesh tint. A couple little highlights. Take in more purple. Crimson. Just putting that up here. All right, I'll take more purple with ultramarine blue and black. And down here is where it gets really dark. Take more of our white with our blue and just get these spots that are coming down here. Filling in more of these dark spaces again. Just a really pretty blue down here. Alright, now we're moving a little closer. We're going to start to get a little warmer and warmer with our colors. So we're mixing more red, cadmium-free red light, or cadmium red light, with white and flesh tint and ochre. I think I want a little crimson in there. Just mixing some purple in here. And we've got some pretty muted, but still kind of warm purple. Just not very vibrant in here. Gets a little darker at the base there. Just kind of picking places that have the same color and just starting to block more of that color in. Taking a little more of my flesh tint and cadmium red light. Take a little more of my purple and white. And more purple. And blue. Just blending my blue back in here. And then my purple. Gonna mix purple and blue together. And the value gets a little darker too. And it slowly builds up and warms back up, coming back up here on these slopes. Get these shadows in here. starting to warm this back up again with my crimson and white. Maybe we could take some flesh tint and ochre and cadmium red light. Just brighten up a couple of these little areas. And brown, blending that in with these dark reds that we had here. Take a little more brown for the top of this one. I'm gonna take a little break from that back area and start working on this just to switch it up a little. Mixing my ochre with my cadmium red light, some flesh tint. This is all gonna go right there. We'll start to blend this with a little purple. Keep cooling it down. And we'll take more purple. A little black. More purple. Black. Little crevice in here. It's a little darker. One down there. And let's take more of our crimson color. It's white. Just get this ledge all painted in there. Throw some blue in here too. Got that all covered. Take some more flesh tint, and we're just gonna cover up this part. And we'll take some burnt sienna, burnt umber, Yeah, now I got that covered. That's good. Gonna go back to my smaller brush, take some white and my light red. Just try to get a couple more little highlights in here and cover up more of this white space. Okay, let's block this whole section in with this lighter color. Gonna mix some purple and my crimson. And more of this light gray, purpley color. Go back to my crimson here. Okay, now let's just take some purple. Just kind of outlining this section. Add a little more blue in there. It's really dark right here too. You can take a little bit of these warmer colors, put them right in here. Locking in a few more of these little shadows. Adding a few more little bits of brushstroke here so to help build up what's going on. Maybe we can take a little more of our purple with some crimson. Darken up a couple of these. A little crimson with my burnt sienna. More purple right there. Adding my highlights on there. Go back to our crimson color. And let's mix a little bit. Got a little bit of our crimson and warmer colors on here. Alright, we'll take some more brown and in purple and just get a couple of lines going in here. Show the rocks a little more. And a few more highlights are here to this one. Adjust my flesh tint. Mix a little bit more crimson and sienna in there. Get a little bit there too. Come back to our purple. And it's a little darker, cooler down here. Alright guys, and that is going to be it for today. We'll catch up on this next time. Thanks for watching, and check in for part 2 next week. Bye bye!